Hey, what's up, Cappy? Capricorn, this is G1 Writer with G1 Insights. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, this is your love focus for the month of May 2018. Okay, shout out to you, Capricorn. Okay, your love reading is very, very deep, but it's very good, and I like it. I think it's encouraging. I think it's inspiring, and I would not waste any more of you guys' time, so let's get into it, okay? Now, Capricorn, one of the first things that I wanted to address was all of these different dates, okay, and all of these different planets that are in your sign for the past few months and going on. It has been extremely crazy for a lot of you, okay? Like, you guys have Mars in your sign, you have Pluto in your sign, you have your own ruling planet, Saturn, in your sign, okay? And Saturn is actually retrograde in your sign. So while Mars is making you feel more ambitious and ready to go along, Saturn is saying to pump your brakes, to slow down. And the craziest thing about it all is that Saturn is also a very ambitious planet, very serious, very spiritual, very honest, you know? But Saturn also encourages you to mean business, you know, to mean what you say, to say what you mean, to get down to the grittier things, you know. And Mars is saying, forget all that. Just go ahead. Just go do it, you know. So you got a kind of like a tug of war thing going on with your energy these days, Capricorn. And not only that, but let me tell you a thing or two about Mars. May 16th, give or take a day, Mars will go into Aquarius. So expect a lot of nonsense, expect some conflict, expect some drama. This may be with a family member, this may be with a loved one. It may not even be that serious, but it really just depends, to be honest. It just really depends on what else is in your birth chart, okay? Now, because not for nothing, okay, I don't want to jump ahead, but not for nothing, the 13th, we have Mercury, your sister sign, Virgo's ruling planet. Mercury is Virgo's ruling planet. That is your sister sign. Taurus is also your sister sign, okay? Mercury, the planet of confusion and communication, the planet that causes a lot of conflicts, okay, is going into Taurus. So this is not just about the way you communicate, but it's about being really honest and serious and firm in your decision, while Uranus is also going into Taurus, your sister sign, okay? Uranus expresses a lot of freedom, okay? Wanted to burst out, do something new. So you may be telling your spouse, why can't we do this? Why can't we go somewhere? Why can't we grow together? Why can't we get that car next week? You're going to be feeling really inspired to want to do something crazy, Capricorn. And the thing is, I do see some good news here for you, okay? Big changes. So I do see some good news here for you. However, because of this Mars going into Aquarius and Uranus going into Taurus, you have two fixed signs. Taurus is a fixed sign and Aquarius is a fixed sign. And when you have Uranus and Taurus, that's stubborn, I don't care, I'm going to do what I want to do energy, matching up with that Mars and Aquarius, stubborn, rebellious energy, clash, 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 heads. People are going to be bumping heads, and I don't know if this is going to have anything to do with you at all, but I think it will affect you, Capricorn, because Mars is also in your sign, along with Pluto. Now, Mars is Aries' ruling planet, but it is also Scorpio's ruling planet. So let's talk about Scorpio's energy really quickly, okay? And believe me, this has a lot to do with your love situation, okay? Scorpio full moon is happening April 29th. So that very first week of May is going to be very mysterious for you. You know, ready to be ambitious, ready to take charge of a situation, excuse me. I feel like I just got tongue twisted. So you're going to be feeling really ambitious, ready to charge ahead, ready to take that new gig, ready to get that new job, ready for that promotion, you know, ready to plant those seeds, ready to grow and expand. And yes, you got it made, Capricorn. Even in love, you can expect a lot more harmony this week, okay? Especially that first week of May. A lot more harmony, a lot more peaceful, a lot more calm, okay? The problem is this. That third week of May, around the 13th to the 16th, just as quickly as all this drama rises up, it's going to all come back down. So don't worry, Capricorn. You have a lot of cards here talking about clearing obstacles, getting rid of obstacles, having balance, you know, stating what you need, being firm in your decision, but also having balance. So this is saying, don't get too excited about something, but don't be too gentle and calm and humble about it either. So you are in a tough spot, Capricorn. You gotta be grounded. And thankfully, because you are an earth sign, I don't think you will have a problem doing that. Like I said, it just really depends on what else is in your birth chart, okay? So please check your sun, moon, and rising sign, okay? Because it's going to be very extremely important that you guys are in tune with all these different crazy energies coming around. You have to be grounded, dear love, okay? I cannot stress that enough. I've been trying to let every zodiac sign know that, okay? Now, the 16th. Like I said, Mars is going into Aquarius, so we already know that's a lot of drama, a lot of he say, she say, a lot of pointing fingers, people getting on your nerve, giving you a headache, you know, and you can choose to argue with your spouse, okay, or you can choose to take the latter and be happy and say, the hell with that, I'm not letting that come between me and my spouse. Or you can just be miserable and be upset and have a fight and say things you shouldn't say and kick people out and curse and scream and act a fool. So it's up to you, Capricorn. But the reality still stands. Do you want to be happy? I know the answer is yes, so don't worry about it. But what I'm saying is this. If you're going to be happy, Capricorn, you have to monitor your thoughts and your actions this month, okay? Because that is going to determine your overall energy for the rest of May, but it's also going to determine whether you and your spouse can really stand through all of this, okay? It's up to you. Like I said, it's up to you guys. You are the creator of your destiny, and you do have a choice, Capricorn. You can say, look, I want this to work. I want to get through this. I don't want to fight anymore. Let's make it work. Okay, it's up to you and your spouse. Some couples don't have that bond, you know? But then you might say, you know what? I don't care. I want it to work. You may feel, it may be something as simple as this. For an example, it may be something as simple as this. Your spouse might feel like they need freedom. You might feel like you need freedom. They might feel like they need to get away and take a vacation. You might be like, hey, what about me? I'm the one that work hard, you know? And so that's where the conflict may come from. Or the conflict, again, may not have nothing to do with you. It may be outside drama trying to sneak his way into your world. And because it is involving someone you love, you will naturally get defensive and put up a fight because it's somebody that you care for that's being caught up in this nonsense, okay? So just be thoughtful. You know, I see a lot of paperwork and things that you guys have to do and a lot of contracts and things in your home. This is all in your about yourself and about balancing yourself, Capricorn, balancing your home, balancing your emotions, balancing your mental thoughts, your mental capacity, you know, loving yourself first. You know, it's okay. You know, and I express this, a lot of this to you in your career and life focus about, you know, it's okay to say no. You know, you gotta say no sometimes, Capricorn. And I feel very strangely that even in your love focus, unfortunately, you're gonna have to say no again. You're gonna have to say no. Sorry, I can't do it. You know, look at this. Love yourself first. Yes, love yourself first. You cannot be there for everybody else, Capricorn, when you're always neglecting yourself. Honey, listen to me. Listen to me good. For this same similar energy to come out in your love focus, it tells me that, yes, you have been neglecting yourself way too long. You are not doing some of the things you used to do. You're not happy the way you used to be happy. You're not having fun the way you used to have fun. And this is all because you are trying so hard to please everybody else. You're working hard for everybody else. You're trying to love everybody else. You make so many sacrifices for the one that you love. And sometimes it's okay to make sacrifices. But this season, it's like, look, okay, I really got to get back to me. I love you, Like, you don't understand. I need this job. Like, you don't understand. I need this career. You don't understand. I need this business. Okay? Your spouse may feel like you're not giving them enough attention. Your spouse may feel like you are not loving them that way. Okay? And like I said, Capricorn, you may also be feeling that way. So instead of wasting all this valuable energy arguing and cursing each other out and throwing things at each other, take this energy to say, you know what, let's not fight today. Let's just not fight. Let's not fight. Let's not fight. Okay? Now, like I said, the 13th, Mercury is going into Taurus. The 15th, Uranus is going into Taurus the same day as the Taurus new moon. So, yes, you're going to be feeling excited, ready to celebrate, ready to party, ready to throw it down, okay? Because, like I said, I see big, big, big happy changes here, okay? So, yes, something exciting is coming. What is it? I don't freaking know. Something amazing is coming. It could be pregnancy. It could be a new home, a new car, okay? But I believe that it's something that's going to excite you, but it has a lot to do with papers, okay? Papers, papers, papers. Signing your life away, okay? It's going to get you and your spouse really happy, really excited, okay? I see renovations, different things happening for you guys. However, in that same week of that new moon, just as happy as you're going to get, something dumb is going to happen and it's going to throw you off a little bit because it's going to be like you weren't really expecting it, right? And it's going to be like, okay, crap, how do we deal with this now, you know? But thankfully, the universe is working in your favor, thankfully. Okay, so like I said, it all depends on how you and your spouse look at this. You can look at this and say, you know what, it's cool. Let's take a deep breath. Let's work through this. Or you can go ahead and throw dishes at each other if you want to. Okay? But I don't think that's going to get either one of you anywhere. I think that you guys just need to go talk it out and sit down somewhere. Okay? Because I also do see forgiving and learning here. So I believe that the way you may have handled things in the past, maybe like being really stubborn, not really caring, throwing things, cursing people out, you know, not really just kind of thinking you know it all. Capricorn, you know, you got to release that type of energy because you cannot go into this season with the same mentality that you have had over the last 4 years. So you have to really just switch it up on people, you know, change your mind. Say, you know what? Nope, I'm not going to even give you the time of the day. I'm not going to argue with you. I refuse to fight with you. I am ready to be happy. And I'm sure with that positive energy and with that positive turnaround, your spouse will have no choice but to give in and say, okay, I love you too, you know? So don't go into the season with the same type of energy that you've always had, you know, ready to argue, put your foot down. Everybody already know you're the baddest. We already know you're serious and you mean business. You don't always have to prove that. This is the one time in your life you don't have to prove who you are. People already know who you are. You don't have to do that. You don't have to go around trying to show everybody your worthiness because people already see it. Because if they didn't, they wouldn't come to you, Capricorn. So understand that about yourself. This is a season for you to love yourself first. And I even said the same similar messages to you during your Korean life focus. So it's telling me that this is a lot of strong energy for you. Now, for some of you that are single, okay, in order I see new love here. Okay, so yes, like I said, big happy changes. So a new love, new engagement, new marriage, whatever. Like I said, something exciting is going to happen. You may get engaged that week. Who knows? You may actually get pregnant that week or decide to adopt the kid. I don't know, but something amazing and exciting is happening. And remember, like I said, the universe is working at your favor. So the only thing you could do right now is to trust your inner guidance, trust that your feelings are real, follow, you know, and trust your intuition. Do not allow people to, my leg is hurting. So do not allow people to try to manipulate you or to take advantage of you. If something is making you uncomfortable, I need you to speak up, Capricorn, and let them know, look, this is not right. This is making me unhappy. I'm uncomfortable. I'm not satisfied with these results. I think that you need to do this over. Okay, you need to speak up, Capricorn. It's not always, and you, I don't think you have a problem with speaking your mind, but sometimes you don't always like saying certain things because you feel like it may hurt someone's feelings. I mean, you do have a heart after all, right? So You know, but overall, take time to heal and release the past. Release anything that's old and negative and toxic. You want to do that, okay? You want to clear the way for greater things to come to you, because that is what I see for you. Clearing the way, dear love. Clear the way. Remove obstacles. Do not go into the season with the same mentality, the same attitude, the same I don't care mentality. No, no, no. This is a new you. New you, Capricorn, okay? So forgiving and learning, okay? As you release and heal the past, you will experience more love in your present moment. So again, with that new love, don't go into this new love relationship with the same old energy. If you are already coupled up, this is time for you to redevelop your relationship, okay? Start over. Think of something exciting. Buy some new lingerie. Go shopping. Do something nice for your spouse. Show them that, you know what? I do appreciate you. I do love you. However, I have to focus on me because I've been putting me off for a really long time. They may not understand right then and there, but overall, the more passionate you are and the more kind you are, okay, I feel like earth signs, I feel like you guys' energy are very similar to water signs this season. And I think it's because you both are going through some dramatic changes, which is ironic, really. Okay, but nevertheless, Capricorn, love yourself first. Your self-respect makes you more romantically attractive. And the more people see you taking care of yourself and standing up for yourself and appreciating who you are and valuing your self-respect, trust me, people won't continue to treat you the way they treat you, and they won't feel like they have to take advantage of you. And this does include your spouse or your family or close friends. They will have no choice but to respect your opinion and the way that you feel. Okay? Now, when it comes to love, for a lot of you that have been going through some things with a loved one, okay, you don't want to, again, just be aware of your thoughts and your actions, because I feel like the love you guys have shared is eternal, regardless of the situation, okay? You gotta forgive, Capricorn. Don't be so stubborn. Forgive and move on. What happened has happened. You know, you can't take it back. You know, so just try to forgive each other and let it go. You know, I'm sure that you guys have been through worse than this. So don't allow one little situation that week to determine your whole future, okay? Like I said, I do see big happy changes here. So it lets me know, with that forgiveness and you letting your spouse know, look, I am sorry, I do love you, I'm sorry I haven't been as attentive, or I'm sorry I haven't really been there for you the way you needed me to, but I just really needed some me time. Just communicate, Capricorn. You don't have to throw a fit, you don't have to throw dishes, you don't have to storm out, you don't have to pack your shit. You know, just let them know, I'm sorry, okay? I'm not trying to be mean. Just talk, okay? Just communicate what you really feel. But I do see that you guys have been neglecting yourself a lot. And maybe that's something that your spouse didn't quite understand before. And even if you are single, you still have been neglecting yourself. A lot of you really have. And this is the time to say, you know what? I'm going to go find me a new man. Or I'm going to go find me a new girlfriend. And she's going to be fabulous. She's going to be intellectual and sexy and everything in between, okay? So really, really take time to focus on self-love this month. Even in your relationships, it's okay to tend to people and to be there and to do what others need you to do. But you got to take time for you, Capricorn. Your energy was so the same way during your career and life focus. I kid you not. So if you guys have not reviewed your career and life focus for the month of May, I strongly advise it, because then this will make a whole lot more sense, okay? So Capricorn, please like, share, and subscribe to my channel. Please like and share this video. Thank you for all your love. Thank you for all the donations. Capricorn, you guys have been amazing. I always have a blast doing you guys reading. Thank you so much for tuning in. My website is www.g1insights.org, or I can also drop my email at the end of the video, so that way you guys can email and reach out to me and let me know if you need a reading or if you just want to simply donate. I don't know. It's up to you. But I do love you, Capricorn. So bye. Enjoy your May and your spring. See you in June. Bye.